Welcome. In this brief video demonstration, we'll show you how you can create self-updating Windows Delphi applications using TWebUpdate and our companion tool, TMS UpdateBuilder. We'll use the VCL TWebUpdate component, which is a component that can manage self-updating Windows Delphi applications with update packages coming over HTTP, FTP, a local drive, or a network drive. The criteria to determining if there is a new version of the application available can be based on the application version information. This can be based on a date, on a file size, checksum of a file, or you can define your own custom criteria. The TWebUpdate component cannot update the application itself, but it can be instructed to. For example, you can update application data or only update application data, or perform partial application updates, such as updating only plugins, modules, etc. And we have a companion too, the TMS Update Builder tool. This is a tool that helps you in building the update package. The Update Builder tool can be told to deploy on a server or somewhere on your network drive. The Update Builder tool can be downloaded from our website. You can find the free download for the Update Builder tool for TWebUpdate by going to the Web Update page. Let's get started. In this demonstration, we'll show you how you can add these self-updating capabilities to your application in less than 5 minutes. Let's switch to Delphi, where we have our first application ready, which is a VCL application. First, let's save this project into a folder designated for this specific project. This will be the folder under Projects, My App. So here, we will save the project and generate the project in this folder. Here are the files that belong to this project. The version information can be accessed via the application options. Here, we have the default version information included in our executable, and this is set as default to version 1.0. Now let's introduce the Web Update component. We drop it on the form, then we'll perform a check if there is a new update available when we click this button. Update the question mark, and from here we do nothing more than check to see if there is a new version available. So we use the function new version available that returns true if it finds a new version. And when a new version is found, all we need to do is call do update. We will need to instruct our component's web update where to find the control file for the update process. And this is configured via the properties of this component. Here, we specify that we will be using a file-based update. So no HTTP or FTP download is necessary. And in a moment, we'll generate the update control file. We'll need to specify here in the URL where this update control file is located. Now, it's time to start Update Builder. This is our Update Builder tool. Here, we can add the list of files that will be involved in the application update. I will add the executable itself, as this is the executable that will be replaced. It asks after I edit the first file if this is the actual application that needs to be self-updating, and so I say yes. By default, it has chosen a not compressed file that will be downloaded. I will instead specify that I want to use a CAB file compression. Here, I specify the application folder, meaning that of course I want my application to be updated in the folder where my application itself is installed. When I go to Global Settings here, I can define that the criteria for doing the update will be based on the version information that is inside my executable here in this case project 1. So let's save this Update Builder project. And I will save it in the same folder where my application executable is located. So this is the Update Builder project file. I've also created a separate folder. This is the folder where I want my update package to be generated. So we can do a preview of the Update Builder control file. Here you can see that this is the version criteria and the file with which this version info will be compared is specified here. These are the files that will be downloaded. Here is more information that this is the file that contains the new executable that should replace the existing application executable. So now I can, in fact, already do a first build of this project. Now, it is compressing our executable and is generating the CAB file and the control file. You can see these files being generated. Now the control file is the file that WebUpdate will use to handle the update process. So I need to specify this in my Delphi application for the URL property for my WebUpdate component. And here it will be project1.inf. With this in place, we can already do a test. So we click Update, and of course there's no update available. So now I close this project. And what I will do is keep but set aside the first version of our application. This one here. Let's make here a new folder where I specify version 1.0. Assuming that this is the version that is deployed for your customer. And so there is, of course, no update available. So what we'll do now is create a new version, version 1.1 of this application. To make it visible that this is version 1.1, let's add an important new feature, which is a new label. Saying, I'm version 1.1. And of course, I need to specify the version info and set it to 1.1. Let's update everything consistently to version 1.1. So now I can compile this application. Of course, when I run application 1.1, there will obviously not yet be an update available. So what I need to do now is create a new update package, an update package for version 1.1. So let's delete the previous update package. And here, our Update Builder has seen that we have now generated version 1.1. Update Builder has in fact extracted this information from our application executable. And so we can go to this page to create a new update package. This package for 1.1 will be generated in this folder. It can also be uploaded to your WRAP server if you configured it to do so. And so with this package in place, we move back to the folder where I set aside version 1.0 of our application. So when I start this application, obviously the label of version 1.1 is not yet available. If I click Update Now, it has detected that there is an update available, and I can confirm to download this update, which has happened now. And now, this application asks to be shut down and to restart the update being version 1.1. So it has automatically restarted, and as you can see, the version 1.1 label is available. So with this, we round up this brief demonstration of using TWebUpdate and UpdateBuilder to create self-updating Windows Delphi applications. I hope that we've convinced you that it's easier than ever to create self-updating applications. Thanks for watching.